Thanks, Craig. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Real privilege to stand before you tonight after a really successful season. It's probably, as a coach anyway, and perhaps a CEO and a president, a footy manager, even Hodgie as captain, it's probably the most satisfying time of all when you've had a chance to reflect over the course of the last 7 days. And you get a chance to stand up with the privilege of addressing so many Hawthorn people in the room and celebrate the Premiership year. It's even a greater privilege when it's the third time in a row. I too, like Hodgie, want to acknowledge our players, our full squad, every one of the players on our list, whether they've represented our senior side or not. I speak about the development squad at a tick, but obviously that includes retirees in Lakey and Haley. I'm not sure how many in the room actually observed the retirements of those boys on Tuesday, but what I love reading in the press when they're talking about our players and our club and the way they do things. Those two boys and the way they exited their footy club and their careers, they said with all class, all dignity. Thanks, boys, for the way that you handled yourself on Tuesday. On a note that's just as sad, I suppose, as Lakey and Haley going, it's with a little bit of regret they have to announce that Matt Suckling, who has also been a really fantastic servant of our footy club for a long period of time, has exercised his right through free agency to accept an offer from the Western Bulldogs to play his footy there for the next 3 years. So we wish you all the best, suckers. I know that we've picked up Chip Frawley through free agency. We've lost a couple of soldiers along the way through free agency too. That's the environment of our game now. We've perhaps known about it for some time with Suckers that it might be a chance that might happen. And this is a guy that has committed fully to his footy club and his journey. He hasn't had it easy at any stage. But he's played over 100 games for our club. He's a two-time Premiership player at our club. But more importantly, he's a terrific teammate to those who represent our footy club on game day. So thanks so much, Suckers. And despite that being quite a sad note, a happier note today was when Ridey rang me and said that Ralphie Schellmakers has signed a new contract with the footy club. Yeah, go to you, Ralphie! To Box Hill and the boys that represented that side so well throughout the course of the year. Disappointing finale to the year, not being able to get the win in the grand final. But we're so stoked with the work that Marco did with the Box Hill side, both the Box Hill players as well as the Hawthorn listed players. To Rob McCartney and Damien Carroll that assisted so ably in setting up that program with Marco, to Big Monkey and also Nita, who provided so much guidance to some of our younger key position players in particular in rucks. But those five guys have been enormous for the development of our younger players. As we've seen with Suckers, we've also seen with Taylor Geray and other players through our footy club. Billy Hartung's going through it at the moment. It's very rare that players come in their first year of footy and make a significant contribution straight away. This club has got a fantastic history of players doing an apprenticeship. Sometimes it's been 2 or 3 years, and I know that I've spoken at this evening in previous years where I've spoken about the Tucks and the Dipy Domenicos and the Gowers and the Condons and fantastic, the Morrisseys, the list goes on and on of fantastic premiership players at this footy club that spent a lot of time playing reserve grade footy. And we don't apologise to our young players for making them do the tough yards. We think it's a great foundation for them to one day represent the Hawthorn Footy Club and compete genuinely for silverware. So thanks to Marco and Rob, to DC Monkey, to Nita, for your work with developing those guys, your patience and providing terrific stability for our senior program. Can I acknowledge the senior 22 on grand final day versus the West Coast Eagles? Hawthorn's always been about family, our footy club, but more significantly than that, perhaps, it's always been about team. And I'm not sure if Kanga and Dulcie are here tonight, but we're still getting the benefit of what Kanga indoctrinated into our footy club as far back as the 50s and 60s. And those values that were indoctrinated so many years ago, really, really proud that they're very much alive today. So thanks, Kanga. Fags and myself and our other coaches have done a lot of travelling over the journey, and one of the clubs that we've got enormous respect for and we visited on a couple of occasions, the San Antonio Spurs. We did produce a little bit of a video that acknowledged the Spurs and their victory last year in the NBA and how stability, continuity, really, really good values, and players perhaps playing their footy club, making the sacrifice to play beneath their market value, which is really, really difficult in America in particular. To play beneath their market value and just want to play for the team and play team football. And we showed a video last year that had Magic Johnson, who is one of the most decorated players that ever played NBA in America, commentating on the San Antonio Spurs. And we've put together a bit of vision that has the commentary talking about the San Antonio Spurs, but the vision is all about Hawthorn, and we're so proud that the things that we've seen in the San Antonio Spurs and some of these other great organisations around the world, all about team, all about sacrificing for one another, that we saw on grand final day last week against the West Coast Eagles, and we've seen it so consistently with this Hawthorn side and this group of players for a long, long period of time. So let's have a look to the screens and watch what we've got to show about the San Antonio Spurs and Hawthorn.
So many times we promote the individual. Oh, LeBron, Kobe Bryant, Kevin Durant. But then we leave out something that's really unique and special, and that's team and team basketball. I sat there and watched this team carve the Clippers up by playing basic, fundamental basketball, and it was beautiful to watch. It reminded me of my era, the way we used to play the Celtics, just smart and great basketball. And I'm happy that we are seeing it in America. You need to appreciate the San Antonio Spurs and this team, well coached. And I'm just, sometimes you're lost for words. All you need to do is just watch this team and they'll say it all.
If you're a purist about the game of basketball, you watch them play. If you want the glitz and glamour and all the dunks, you maybe focus in on another team. And it's a credit to the organization, the ownership, R.C. Buford, Pop and his staff, and the players. Everybody's in the same circle, and they believe in it. They're not all seeking a lot of glamour and everything else. It's a great way to play the game.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war, you can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck, dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame,
yeah,
and the world's
walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. Are you ever gonna know if you never even try? Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're dead.
A couple of great traditions that you've observed, I'm sure, over the last 3 years with our premiership successes, being the inclusion of families on field after the game. Our players always wear their premiership guernseys over their shirts to celebrate on grand final night, which is another tradition. But speaking of family, like Hodgie, I've also got to acknowledge the families of our staff and our players. To my wife, Karen, I'm only at 50% capacity without your support and guidance. With three children, Steph, Georgia and Matt. Biggest critics, but also my biggest fans. To our footy subcommittee and their partners, can't pump Fags up too much. He's already had a bit too much tonight. But Fags, thanks, mate, and Ursula. Dorothy and Lee, Andy Gowers and Anna, thanks so much for your support, Growler. Righty, I know a really busy time of the year for you, mate, but you've been so instrumental to putting together a list of players that our coaches can work with, and you continue to do so. So thanks, Righty. To Jack Russell and Lee, but Jack, some of the work that you've done with our players has just been first class, and Jack's been involved in league footy since the late 90s. He's involved at the Essendon Footy Club, he's involved at Port Adelaide, he's now been involved at Hawthorn for 11 years. So his involvement at a professional level is about 15 years. He's been involved in six premierships in that time. It tells you a little bit about the contribution that he makes. To Foxy and Sib, thanks so much for your support and being a really, really strong link between footy subcommittee and the board, and the support and stability that the board and the administration gives our subcommittee and our football program is absolutely first class. And finally, Jason Bird and his wife Tracy are such a huge part of the fabric of our footy club. And we thank them so much for being on our subcommittee. Our footy subcommittee, for those in the room who wonder, well, what is that? There's lots of people with lots of responsibilities, and we give all our staff opportunity to make decisions according to the roles that they play at our footy club. But of any decisions of significance, there's not a decision made unless it's been ticked off by that football subcommittee. It doesn't matter whether it's to do with recruiting, it doesn't matter whether it's to do with playing, it doesn't matter whether it's to do with purchasing equipment. Unless it's given the tick by that group, it doesn't get through. So it doesn't allow egomaniacs like myself to take control of our footy program. We want to present tonight a pictorial representation of a week in the life of the Hawthorn Football Club. We're really, really fortunate that a photographer named Michael Wilson has been involved in our club in the last 2 years. You've probably seen some of these photographs on our website. He does an outstanding job. He's got the trust of our players and our staff at our footy club. And this is a week in the life of the Hawthorn Footy Club. It just so happens to be a week in the life of a lead up to a grand final, which is a typical week for the Hawthorn Footy Club. I did hear someone say that you should be humble. Arrogance is a term that we use in our, with our players. There's nothing too humble about that. Thanks, Michael, for the photographs that you took last week and indeed last year. It gives our players and everyone closely associated with our club a really great feel about what it means to be part of Hawthorn. And you'll quite clearly see when we show these pictures on the screen in just a moment, we are a very happy team at Hawthorn. Thank you.
The best fans in the world, there's no question.
Oh, let's go back to the start.
Thank you. Farewell.
That was our anthem for the year. Nobody said it was easy. To our supporters, our members, best supporters in the world, and yes, we need to start again. We're already focusing on 2016. Thank you.